Let's discuss the last topic of the unit, limiting reactant. What is a limiting reactant? It is a reactant which gets completely consumed in a reaction. For example, let us understand this balanced chemical equation where we have 2 mole of hydrogen, 1 mole of oxygen, and they two unite to give 2 mole of water. Now let us take a situation where we have in a reaction mixture 2 mole of hydrogen and 2 mole of oxygen. Now only 1 mole of oxygen will be used in this reaction, so 1 mole will be left over. So we can say here that hydrogen is the limiting reagent and oxygen is the excess reagent. To understand this concept of limiting reactant, let us see this numerical. It is in a reaction, A plus B2 gives AB2. Identify the limiting reagent. Now let us understand this equation. Here we can say that 1 mole of A reacts with 1 mole of B and gives AB2. Or we can also say that A is an atom, B is a molecule. We can say that one atom of A reacts with one molecule of B to give AB2. Now let's see these different questions. First is 300 atoms of A and 200 molecules of B. That is, if we have 300 atoms of A, 200 molecules of B, then what is going to be the limiting reagent? See, 200 molecules of B will react with 200 atoms of A. So we can say that A is the excess reagent and B is the limiting reagent. I hope this is clear. Now let's see the second question. If we have 2 mole of A and 3 mole of B, if we have 2 mole of A and 3 mole of B, then what is the limiting reagent? 2 mole of A will react with 2 mole of B, and so B will be the excess reagent and A will be the limiting reagent. Thus in this reaction, A is the limiting reagent. Now let's see the third condition, where we have 100 atoms of A and 100 molecules of B. If we have 100 atoms of A and 100 molecules of B, then this is a stoichiometric mixture. There is no limiting reagent in this reaction. Let us analyze the fourth condition. 5 mole of A, 2.5 mole of B. If we have 5 mole of A and 2.5 mole of B, now what is going to happen here? 2.5 mole of B will react with 2.5 mole of A. So A is going to be the excess reagent and B is going to be the limiting reagent in this reaction. Now let's see the last condition. When we have 2.5 mole of A and 5 mole of B. So if we have 2.5 mole of A and 5 mole of B, what is going to happen? 2.5 mole of A will react with 2.5 mole of B, and thus B is the excess reagent and A is the limiting reagent. Let's discuss one more numerical based on the concept of limiting reagent. 50 kg of nitrogen and 10 kg of hydrogen are mixed to produce ammonia. Calculate the ammonia formed. Identify the limiting reagent in the reaction, if any. So we have been given in the reaction mixture 50 kg of nitrogen and 10 kg of hydrogen. The two combine to form ammonia. Let's see the balanced chemical equation. Nitrogen combines with hydrogen to form ammonia. We have 1 mole of nitrogen, 3 mole of hydrogen and 2 moles of ammonia. Now let's calculate first the number of moles which will be available from 50 kg of nitrogen. See, if we have 50 kg of nitrogen, the moles will be weight of the substance divided by molar mass. The number of moles will be available from 50 kg of nitrogen will be 1.786 into 10 raised to power 3 moles. And the number of moles of hydrogen available from 10 kg of hydrogen will be weight of the substance, that is 10 into 10 raised to power 3 over 2. So the moles of hydrogen available from 10 kg of hydrogen are 5 into 10 raised to power 3 moles. Now let's see, if we have 1.786 into 10 raised to power 3 mole of nitrogen, we have calculated here. If we have 1.786 into 10 raised to power 3 mole of nitrogen in the reaction mixture, then hydrogen required will be 3 times of this value, because this is what the balanced chemical equation say. So the amount of hydrogen required will be 5.36 into 10 raised to power 3 mole. But 10 kilogram of hydrogen is providing us only with 5 into 10 raised to power 3 mole. From here we can judge that the available moles of hydrogen are this, but required are this. So hydrogen is the limiting reagent. I hope this is clear to everyone. Now, the next question is calculate the ammonia formed. So, we want to find out how much ammonia is formed. From the balanced chemical equation, we can see that if we have 3 mole of hydrogen, we have 2 mole of ammonia. So, if we have 5 into 10 raised to the power 3 mole of hydrogen, then how much ammonia is going to be formed? If we have 3 mole of hydrogen, the ammonia is 2 mole. If we have 1 mole of hydrogen, the ammonia will be 2 by 3. And if we have 5 into 10 raised to the power 3 mole of hydrogen, the ammonia formed will be 3.3 into 10 raised to the power 3 mole. Now we have to calculate the mass of ammonia. So what we will do, we will multiply moles with molar mass and we will get the mass of ammonia, that is 56.1 kg.